we're beautiful.
Capricorn, welcome back to Angel's Light Tarot. Thank you for stopping by for your monthly general love message for July 2020. Okay, Capricorn, let's get right into your love energies for the seventh month of this crazy year, 2020. Angels and guides, positive energy around Capricorn. Yes. Feelings, what is going on in your feeling? Yes, feelings about love. Angels and guides, we're looking for positive energy for Capricorn for the month of July. All right, angels. Let's get into this. Now remember, Capricorn, if this is taking too long, yes, you know what to do. Tick the little button, yes. Positive energy, angels, for Capricorn's love energy for, yes, the month of July. Yes. Moving on to the the other angel deck. Yes, we're putting a lot of love in here for you, Capricorn. Love energy around Capricorn for the month of July. Yes, and one more please from the angel deck. Angels and guides, positive energy for thank you. And I feel like it's this one. Yes. And we're going to add the purple deck. Yes, we are. There's a lot of things going on in your love energy this month. Angels and guides, we're looking for positive energy for Capricorn for the month of July. And of course, we are topping it off with yes, the hummingbird deck. Yes, and we are almost there. I love it when it's so equal. All right, so let me tidy up a little bit. Are you ready? Okay, so the main theme for the month of July, love, we have the silver waterfall, Capricorn, with the angel of guidance, with take your power back, balance, seven of hearts and the five of hearts. So I feel like this month, you are really, really in your feelings. Very emotional when it comes to love this month. I feel like it's time to seek guidance in your love, in your romantic love sector, whether you are with someone or whether you are not with someone. I definitely feel like you're very emotional about love. Now, it says take your power back when it comes to love. Find inner, I feel like maybe you give too much of your energy, you lend too much of your energy to the whole, you know, even if you're not in a relationship, you're thinking a lot about relationships. If you're in a relationship, you're thinking so much about the relationship. With the seven of hearts, it is time to detach. It's time to allow them to be exactly who they are. If you are not in a relationship, I definitely feel like this is probably not a month to get into a relationship because I feel like you're very, very sensitive about love this month. I'm just picking up sensitivity. If you are in a relationship, allow your partner to be exactly who they are, because I feel like your energies are going to go up and down and they can't keep up with your emotions, okay? So step back, do your thing, let them do their thing, no control, and everything is wonderful. Okay, so now when we look at the recent past, we have the manifestation, we have angel of learning, moon cycles, solitude, ace of spades, and the three of hearts. So in the recent past, we have manifestation. You were working on your love. Yes, you were. And with the angel of learning, I feel like you were trying different things in your relationship. But with the moon cycles, I feel like I'm going to just say it, okay? You were moody. Okay, I'm just going to put it out there. Either you were moody or your partner was moody. Okay? All right. Now, I feel like because of that, you kind of stay to yourself a bit. You were doing some inner work and I feel like there was an issue. There was things like, you know, I'm really uncertain about where I am in love. So I'm just going to pull back and do me. Okay. All right. Now, When we look in the middle of the month, we have the sacred woman. We have the angel of spiritual tempest. Breathe. Yes, yes, yes. Emotional loss. Seven of diamonds and the king of hearts. So I feel like in the middle of the month, I see you doing a lot of work when it comes to your romantic relationships. A lot of healing that is going on. With the spiritual tempest, I see that you might be tempted to... Okay, not do the work. I'm just saying, not do the work. So take a breath. Take a deep, deep, deep breath. Yes, stay on your path, all right? With the emotional, with the heartache and loss, I definitely feel like with the king, with the seven of hearts, you are kind of in that situation where you might lose your patience. You might lose your temper. You might, yes. But the king of hearts says... Regain your power in your relationship. Take back your power by not giving it away, by losing your temper or losing your patience and blah, blah, blah. Yes, take back your power. Put that crown on. Yes, let them see the kingly you. Now, moving on to the end of the month, we have the boundaries. Yes, yes, yes. And we have sweet The sweet shyness, angel sweet shyness, brilliant idea, reward and recognition, ace of hearts, and the four of diamonds. So I feel like within your love, romantic relationships, whether you are in them or potential, you're setting boundaries by the end of the month. With the sweet shyness, I don't see you being aggressive with these boundaries. Yeah, but then you have this brilliant idea. And then I feel like whatever this, the way you set your boundaries in your love relationships, I feel like it's not like anyone else's. This is a brilliant idea, and I feel like you will be rewarded for that. The Ace of Hearts, I see you getting kudos. I see you saying, yeah, I did do something different, and they did notice that I did something different. With the Four of Diamonds is definitely bringing you security in your love. Yes, yes, yes. So good for you, Capricorn. Now, when we, you're just, you know what? You should just get all kinds of stars this month, okay? You know when we were kids and we got stickers from our teachers? Yeah, you deserve stickers this month, okay? All right, now, when we look at your bonus, you have the dating card and the inner peace with the divine feminine, the angel of mother love, hello from heaven, temptation, 10 of diamonds, and the 8 of clubs. So looks like you're doing some good stuff here. So the dating in your love, if you are single, yes, you are out there dating. If you are in a relationship, you are dating, yes, within your bond. It is bringing inner peace, yes, with the divine feminine. You know what? You're looking good, okay? That's all I'm saying. I don't know what you're doing. I don't know if you're working out. I don't know if you're wearing a different cologne or perfume. I don't know what it is, but they see you as ooh la la. That's all I'm gonna say is ooh la la, right? With the angel of mother love, you're giving off an energy that is very soothing, that is very, I feel like it's comforting. I feel like this energy that you're giving off is very comforting. Hello from heaven. I feel like even your ancestors that have crossed over, I hear they're saying, you know what? We're watching. And you're doing a good job, okay? You're definitely doing a good job. Now, with the temptation card, I definitely feel you being tempted. But with the 10 of diamonds, I feel like no matter what you do, I'm just going to say it. No matter what you do with the 10 of diamonds, success is yours. With the 8 of clubs, success is yours. So you have done the work. You've gotten control of your emotions. They have noticed it. Whether you are in a relationship, a potential relationship, they have noticed that you've done it. You're not flying off at the handle. You're not getting upset at the least little thing. You're putting on your crown and you're just letting, yes, yes, yes. And that is so, I'm gonna say that's so sexy. They just like, wow, that is a turn on. That is just like, whoa, they're not doing their typical, right? So whatever you're doing, Capricorn, keep doing it because you're going to be rewarded for this. Look at this, recognition and reward. What you're doing keep doing it. Please keep doing it because you will be rewarded, you with the Ace of Hearts. So, Capricorn, detach. Allow them to be exactly who they are. Yes, 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 yes. You're like, you're in your feelings, like, what? I can't do that. Yes, you can, because you can't control anyone else but you. So when you start controlling your own emotions around the situation, then, you know, it's like, you know, when people get used to something, and they get used to something, they're like, they're used to you reacting a certain way. And when you don't react that way, oh, now you have their attention. Oh yeah, now you have their attention in a positive way. So I send you joy, namaste, and much, much love sent your way.